This is my homemade 6 meter band 50 megahertz transceiver based on the BITX principles. It has only a few knobs, volume and on off. And this is frequency. And we have now 1 kilohertz steps. And when you push the dial, you can choose other steps. As a microphone, I have a very old one that's connected normally to a Philips cassette recorder from the 60s or 70s. And that was the idea about this transceiver, to see what I can use, what I have already. I will show you some construction details. First, the enclosure. As you can see, it is already from a citizen band transceiver. I made a new front on it. And normally the speaker is on the bottom, but as I have the transceiver normally laying on the table, I thought the speaker on the top is likely better. What you also can see is a connector, USB connector, for the Arduino that is in it, that takes care of the frequency control. After opening, you can see the speaker wires, of course, and therefore I made a circle on the PCB to ensure that I have enough space for the speaker. I did some shielding for the Arduino. I'm not sure if it helps. Also for the mixer I made some shielding. And I'm sure that it helps. Normal display, Arduino, and I will come back to this details in the next overview with the block schematic. Final amplifier and an additional filter. As you can see, I removed the original PCB and I made just a double-sided copper board on it that I could use to add the individual circuits. If you look to the other side, you see all the wiring. That's one of my construction techniques. I do the circuits on the other side of the board, drill a hole and then do coax cables or feed-throughs with capacitors for the different voltages. And here's a small relay that I switch the voltages with. Output power of this transceiver on 50 MHz is about 3 watts. Not much, but the enclosure was not large enough to do to get more power out of it. We go to the block schematic and to the individual circuits to show what I made different. This is the block schematic I used. As you can see, maybe it is the same block schematic that I used for the BITX17 that I made a presentation about before. I will zoom in on the first blocks
from microphone and the loudspeaker, how I manage that. These are some of the elements you will find back in the transceiver. Enough now for this episode. If you like this project and want to follow it, please subscribe and you will be notified when the next episode will be present. See you!